COVID-19 and brains. What scientists know so far. SARS-CoV-2 can infect several types of human cells. This may cause the immune system to go into overdrive. Thus, many patients experience severe inflammation due to COVID-19. One mystery begs to be solved. How does the coronavirus trigger brain inflammation? According to the Washington Post, the US CDC warns that airborne debris from sewing into the bone could be an infectious hazard. With so many deaths, scientists had no choice but to do it to learn more about COVID-19. Scientists had to take the risk because many patients reported visual and auditory problems, vertigo and tingling sensations, among others. All these could be considered neurological in nature, and if true, the coronavirus must be attacking the human brain. Like most coronavirus infections, COVID-19 begins when SARS-CoV-2 enters the nasal cavity, where it starts to hunt for host cells. Many cells in the respiratory system have ACE2 receptors, which the virus needs to infect. In the lungs, the invasion may result in respiratory problems. In the nasal cavity, the invasion may affect the olfactory mucosa, which may explain the loss of smell. Then, how can the virus affect the brain? A study in April published in the journal Brain investigated the link between COVID-19 and neurological symptoms. Although brain autopsies confirmed the symptoms were real, researchers couldn't find viral proteins in the samples. The RNA levels were either low or undetectable, depending on the technique used. Study author Peter Cattle suggested that the low RNA levels might be in the membrane around the brain. Despite not much virus found in the brain, autopsies hinted at damage in the brains of deceased patients. Thin slices of brain tissue under microscopes showed two main problems. One, infarctions were common due to dead tissue around blocked blood vessels found in the brain's gray matter. Blocked blood vessels would cause the tissues to suffocate and die from lack of oxygen. And two, immune cells in huge numbers were found in the brainstem, cerebellum, and other areas. Immune cells called microglia would attack dying or dead neurons. With no virus found in swarm neurons, researchers suggested autoimmunity. If HIV would suppress immune response from the beginning, COVID-19 could spawn an immune system on steroids. The team is now making a follow-up study for the brains of patients who had COVID and recovered, however, died later on.